In today's lecture, we are going to study a poem, Shall I Compare Thee, composed by William Shakespeare. Here is the photo of William Shakespeare. See, it is the birthplace of Shakespeare, Stratford-upon-Avon. And it is the river on which the city was situated. This river provided enough field to Shakespeare to write about nature. Shakespeare was fascinated by the beauty of nature and he took inspiration from the lap of this nature. He was born on 26th April 1564. He passed away on 23rd April 1616. The birthplace is Stratford-upon-Avon. He was a British playwright, poet, actor, widely regarded the greatest writer in the English language. We can say that he was an Elizabethan writer. He wrote both tragedies and comedies. A Midsummer Night's Dream, King Lear, Macbeth, Othello, historical plays and poems. He also wrote many sonnets, 154 sonnets, which are addressed to his friend W.H. and a dark lady. And before coming to the poem, I would like to discuss about the form of sonnet, the type of sonnet. The birthplace of sonnet is Italy. It has its Greek origin. The Italian poet Petrarch started to write in this form. It was a poem of 14 lines. There are two types of sonnets. One is the Petrarchan sonnet, which is also called as the Italian sonnet, classical sonnet, and the Miltonic sonnet. And next is the English sonnet, which is also popularly known as the modern sonnet. It was brought to England in the 16th century by Sir Thomas Watt and Henry Herbert. Shakespeare used this form so much that it was also named as the Shakespearean sonnet. There's another type of sonnet that is called a Spenserian sonnet. Before coming to the sonnet, I would like to explain some literary terms about this sonnet. Octave, the stanza of 8 lines. Sextet, the stanza of 6 lines. Couplet, the stanza of 2 lines. Quatrain, the stanza of 4 lines. It is written in the ambic pentameter. When I say that it is written in the ambic pentameter, it means the unstressed syllable is followed by the stressed syllable. The rhyme scheme of the sonnet, of the English sonnet, of the Shakespearean sonnet is ABAB, CDCD, EFEF, GG. The rhyme scheme of the Miltonic sonnet is ABBA, ABBA, CDE, CDE. Now come to the structure of the poem. What happens in the Shakespearean sonnets? That the poet develops his idea in the first 3 quatrains and jumps to the conclusion in the couplet in the last part of the sonnet. He concludes in the couplet, in the last 2 lines. What happens in the Miltonic sonnets? That the poet develops his idea into the octave part of the sonnet and he changes mood with the beginning of the 9th line, with the beginning of the sextet. We can say he develops the idea into the octave and comes to the conclusion in the sextet part, that is the structure of the poem. Generally, the theme of the sonnet is love, friendship, mortality, immortality, the usual topics of life and culture. Now, here is a poem, Shall I Compare Thee, written by William Shakespeare. See what when the poem begins. First, I would like to read this poem. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Here, summer's day means the beauty of the summer. the beauty of the spring. Thou art more lovely and more temperate. This poem is addressed to his friend W.H., who are the patron of Shakespeare. Next, the poet, the wind do shake the darling birds of May, the darling flowers of the spring season. Summer's lease means summer's lifetime hath all too short a date. Sometimes to hold the eye of heaven shines, and often his gold complexion dimmed, and every fear from fear sometime declines, by chance or nature's changing course untrimmed. But thy eternal summer means the quality of his friend, the internal quality of his friend, shall not fade, nor lose possession of that thou fear thou owest. Nor shall death bring thou wanderest in his shade, wherein in eternal life to time thou growest. So long as man can breathe or eyes can see, so long live this, and this gives life to thee. This is sonnet. See in what manner the poet addresses this sonnet to his friend W.H. The poet immortalizes his friend by describing his good quality in this poem. The poet also believes the art of poetry is immortal in comparison to any other art. And the poet says, the poet asks a question to his friend that whether he should compare the beauty of his mind and heart to the beauty of the summer, to the beauty of the spring season. The beauty of the spring season is for the short time, for the limited time. It is transitory. And the poet recalls, thou art more lovely and more temperate. The poet says the qualities of friends are lovely and more mild in nature. In this manner, the poet wants to say, the poet compares the beauty of the mind, the beauty of the heart, the beauty of the nature. The poet believes the beauty of the summer's day, the beauty of the spring is for short time, for the limiting time. On the other hand, the beauty of the heart, the beauty of the mind is permanent in comparison to the beauty of the nature. That's why in the third line, the poet says, the rough winds do shake the darling birds of May. The rough winds of the winter destroy the beauty of the spring season. The lovely flowers of the spring season are deserted by the coming of the winter, by the biting winds of the winter season. And the poet wants to say that the ups and downs of life destroy the beauty of the spring season. And summer's lease hath till too short a date. Summer means the lifetime, lease means lifetime of the summer, the lifetime of this. The spring season is only for short time. It is short dated. It is not for the all time. It is not immortal. It is mortal. Indirectly, the poet wants to say that as the beauty of the spring for short time, the beauty of the summer time is for limited time. In the same manner, the physical beauty is also for limited time. After some time, it passes away. In the next quatrain, the poet declares, sometime to hold the eye of heaven shines. Eye of means the sun. Here the poet is talking about the beauty of the sun. What happens? The sun is bright. The sun is hot. It shines in the sky. But even his golden complexion, his golden color of the sun is made dim, is eclipsed by the passing of a single cloud. See in what manner the brightness of the sun is eclipsed by the passing of a single cloud. The poet wants to say that the beauty is not permanent. And even the brightness of the sun is made dazzled by the passing of a same cloud, say by the passing of a single cloud. In the same manner, the beauty is not permanent. If it declares in every fine words, what are the fine words? That every fear from fear sometime declines. Whatever the beautiful in this world is, it is subject to decline, it is subject to decay, it is subject to change. Nothing is permanent. Beauty is not permanent. Whatever the beauty is, whatever the fear is, the fearest from fear is subject to death. In this manner, the poet declares that beauty is not permanent. As the summer beauty is not permanent, in the same manner, physical beauty is not permanent. it is dazzled, it is eclipsed by the circumstances, by the opposite circumstances. By chance or nature changing course, it is the changing course, it is in natural way that the beauty is subject to change. And further the poet declares, Shakespeare believes that the lines of poetry are immortal. They are not subject to change. They are not subject to decay. And moreover, the poet wants to say that the eternal summer of his friend, the eternal, the qualities of his friend are permanent. They are immortal. And the poet declares that his immortal qualities are not going to fade, are not going to pass, are not going to be forgotten. Why? This is the question arises. The poet further says, nor lose possession of that fear thou owest. The poet further declares that his friend is also not going to lose the possession of those qualities which he possesses. In the third line, even death will not be able to bring his great quality. Okay, death may take him physically, but his qualities are permanent. His qualities are eternal. Even death will not be able to touch those great qualities. In this manner, the poet praises the good qualities of his friend. He poet declares that time will not be able to finish the good quality of his friend. Okay, time destroys the physical human body. It takes away the physical mortal body, but the qualities remains. Qualities does not die with the man. Qualities remain alive even after death. The good qualities are immortal. And in the first three quatrains, the poet develops an idea and develops the idea that the beauty of the nature is not permanent. The darling birds of the maize, the darling flowers of the spring season are destroyed, are deserted by the coming of the winter. Even the brightness of the sun is destroyed by the passing of a single cloud. It is not permanent, it is deserted, it is spoiled. It is the course of nature, it is the law of nature, that whatever is beautiful in this world is subject to change, is subject to decline. In the third quatrain, the poet declares the eternal summer, the eternal qualities are not going to end with the time. The eternal qualities of friends are not going to die with the death. Death will not be able to touch those great qualities. And in the last two lines, the poet declares, the poet believes that the art of poetry is immortal. That's why the poet declares, so long as man can breathe or eyes can see, till the last day of judgment, so long live this poetry is alive. And this poem, this gives life to means this life, this poetry, this poem gives life to his friend. Through this poem, the poet Shakespeare makes his friend immortal, that his great qualities are mentioned in this poem, and this the art of poetry is immortal. That's why the poet has made his friend immortal. Man passes away, body passes away, but the good qualities remain alive. The good qualities do not die with the time. In the last two lines, the poet concludes. The poet jumps to the conclusion and says that so long as man can breathe or eyes can see, till the last day of judgment, the man is able to breathe, the man is able to see. Till that time, so long live this, means this poem is alive till the last time. And this poem gives life to his friend, that means his friend WH. In this manner, the poet addresses his friend, the poet immortalizes his friend, the poet immortalizes the good qualities of his friend, and the poet says that the physical beauty is not permanent, but the eternal qualities are permanent. In seeing what manner the poet takes the picture of the summer beauty. It is the summer beauty. It is beauty of the spring. It is full of charm. It is full of attraction. But when the winter comes, what happens? This beauty is deserted. This beauty is no more. And in this manner, the poet compares the qualities of his friend with the beauty of the nature. The beauty of the nature is transitory, not permanent. On the other hand, the good qualities are permanent. They do not die. The dying person, they are eternal, they are immortal. Thanks.